The first solution is acceptable for the most part. It solves the problem of two surfaces being in the same location. However, it does change the geometry of the model, which might not be acceptable. Also, even surfaces that are near each other can still have z-fighting problems, since the z-buffer has limits on its precision. So, this solution works, but is not optimal. The second solution sounds nice. A new graphics card is always fun, but it doesn't help at all. Since both surfaces are in an identical location, which one happens to be closer is entirely arbitrary. Another GPU can, and will, give you a different view of z-fighting. So even if you like the z-fighting effect, you can't control it if your users are on different machines with different GPUs. The third answer, switching to another rendering algorithm, again will just cause different precision errors to show up. The underlying problem of two surfaces being in the same place is a modeling error, and can't be solved by rendering. The fourth answer, removing the bottom part of the leg that overlaps with the foot, is certainly the cleanest solution. This is also the most efficient answer, as making the object smaller will mean it covers less pixels and so causes less work.